Okay, everybody, welcome back. This video is for the Hidden Woodsmen, my buddy Malcolm. He makes a whole bunch of different stuff out of Cordura and Silnai and the like. So I've got a range of his bags here, starting with the smallest one, which is multicam. This is with the zipper lock top. This is my water filter bag. So in here, I've got the Sawyer Mini. Good for 100,000 gallons because you can backwash it out. Got the bag that the Sawyer Mini uses. Wrap those together. There's a straw attachment for the Sawyer Mini where you can attach that and drink out of your water source. There is the back flush syringe. So you take that, fill it there with clean water, put it on the outflow tube, and blast it back through there. You can do that once, you can even do it two or three times to make sure you're effective. So that's it in there. In my little survival tin, I've got some water purifying tablets, so if I don't have the ability to use this, or if I lose this, or if something happens to break, which is almost impossible, there's nothing to break, then I have a backup in there, but I don't carry it in the same package as this water filter. So I zip that up. I like to use this with the zip lock tab versus tie up, because I think it seals up real well, but it also breathes. This Cordura is treated for waterproofness, water resistance I should say, and also fire resistance, so it's a pretty all-around good kit. So that's the smallest bag. The next bag that comes up is the fire pouch. Two belt loops on the back, clip buckle in the front with a cinching strap. In here I've got a few things. So I'm on a trip right now camping, so I don't have the stock as full as I'd like. This was cattail fluff, and I also had a bundle of dryer lint and some jute twine in there, which I've been using, so it's not as full as it is when I leave for a trip. Got some waterproof and some Strike Anywhere matches and a bit of Striker. And a film canister. Some of your older viewers might recognize that. I don't even know where you could go buy one of those today. I have a piece of fatwood to play with. I have my Striker from Scott at Wessex Blades. It's a big one, but I try to use stuff that's renewable more often than using stuff that is not renewable. And my most common use for fire lighting is a good old cheap lighter. You can buy these by the dozen. They're inexpensive, and you can keep refilling and getting new ones. When there comes a time, perhaps, when these are not available, that's when I start using this stuff. Use my matches as necessary. And if I really want to go old school, I can get into this little bag, which has my flint, my steel, some birch bark, and I think one piece of charred cloth left in there. So I take this out at scouts if I want to show off, so to speak, to the beavers or the cubs and show them something a little different. So that's my second bag, fire pouch. The third pouch is, Malcolm sells this as a coffee bag, but what I use it for is for another water filter. So if I have another system of water filtration, I'll untie the top. This is in Marpat. This one, I forgot to mention, was in Coyote. In here, I have my water filter. Cleaning kit, repair kit, intake tube, outflow tube. This goes into your wide mouth Nalgene or stainless steel. And then, like I said, the water pellet. So I can put this in and clarify chemically, I can clarify physically, or I can clarify water with my Sawyer Mini. This one fits all in here, push it off this side. And last but not least, in Coyote, this one I think Malcolm has as a tinder bag that I carry food in. So, spare water bottle, a couple of sticks of honey and some tea bags, some MRE equipment. This is cocoa beverage powder, and this is a chocolate dairy shake powder. And then, if I want to get old school, again, biscuits and gravy from Mountain House. So that all fits easily into this tinder bag. I've fit four Mountain House pouches in here with not too much hassle, so it holds quite a bit. Again, these guys are all handmade by Malcolm. Well-stitched, over-stitched, if anything. Durable, water-resistant, fire-resistant, and reasonably priced. So I highly recommend all these products. I paid for all these. I don't have any freebies here for Malcolm. I'm not on his payroll. I'm not an advertisement or a salesman. I just like his stuff. I like to support people that make good stuff. And this is one of those guys. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you in the next one.